New Year. May God bless you and your family and your plans. And glory to God in the highest heaven and peace to us on earth. I wish you success with flying types and have a year filled with enjoy and enthusiasm. Since today New Year, so I will not describe new topic. I will today just review my previous topic. Just recall how many group homomorphism exist from integer to integer. Just recall, here the mapping is look like f of x equal to ax for all a belongs to integer. That means there exist infinitely many group homomorphism. But how many ring homomorphism exist from the mapping Z to Z? There exist only two ring homomorphism, which I have discussed in my earlier video. But if you don't see my earlier video, at first I will recommend, please see this video. Since here Z is integral domain, so only idempotent element is 0 and 1. So the ring homomorphism here, one fx equal to 0x and other fx equal to 1x. That means the mapping is look like fx equal to 0 and fx equal to x. And these two mapping are ring homomorphism. Now my question, how many group automorphism exist from integer onto integer? Here, automorphism means group isomorphism, and this is possible only this mapping fx equal to x and fx equal to minus x. Since this automorphism contain two element and this is the group structure, so we all of us know any group which contain two element must be cyclic. So automorphism of Z is actually isomorphic to this group Z2. Now think, what will be the automorphism of this ring structure? Here the operation, also multiplication, this will be only isomorphic to only the identity element of a group, because automorphism of group contain this mapping. But for ring homomorphism, only possibility is this. Okay, so automorphism of this group is only isomorphic to the identity element of the group. Now my question, find the ring homomorphism from real number to real number. Since real number is a field, so obviously this is integral domain. So there exist two idempotent elements 0 and 1. So only ring homomorphism fx equal to 0 and other fx equal to x. Therefore, their possible ring homomorphism is 2. Now, here I will use just other method, because here order of R is infinite. Here the multiplicative identity of real number is 1. So we can write f of 1 equal to f of 1 times 1, which is equal to obviously f of 1 times f of 1. That implies f of 1 times 1 minus f of 1 equal to 0. From this line, since R is an integral domain, so this contain no divisor of 0. That means either f of 1 equal to 0 or 1 minus f of 1 equal to 0. That imply f of 1 equal to 1. If f of 1 equal to 1, let n belongs to natural number, then f of n equal to, we can write it as f of 1 plus 1 plus 1, add it n times, which is equal to, by the property of ring homomorphism, n times f of 1. And since f of 1 equal to 1, that means f of n equal to n for all n belongs to natural number. And when n be just negative integer, that means n is less than 0, then f of n equal to, we can write it as f of minus n times minus 1. And by the property of ring homomorphism, this is equal to f of minus n times f of minus 1. This is obviously equal to minus 1. This is the property of ring homomorphism. But here notice, n is less than 0. That means f of minus n obviously greater than 0. That means since positive n, f of n equal to n, that means this value would be minus n times minus 1, which is equal to just n for all n less than 0. That means from this line we can tell fn equal to n for all n belongs to integer. There exists two ring homomorphism, one identity homomorphism and other trivial homomorphism. Notice here R is field. So for any field, there exist only two ring homomorphism, one identity and other trivial. My question, find the ring homomorphism F from Q to Q. Since this is field, obviously there exists two ring homomorphism. One, Fx equal to 0, that means trivial homomorphism. Other is Fx equal to x, that means, since here the element look like P over Q, such the GCD of PQ equal to 1, that means we have to show f of P over Q equal to P over Q. However, for all PQ, P over Q belongs to Q. And if f of P equal to P, and we can write f of P as f of P over Q plus P over Q up to Q times, and which is actually equal to f of P, and which is actually written as Q times f of P over Q, and which is equal to f of P, and f of P equal to P. That means f of P over Q equal to P over Q for all P over Q belongs to rational number. Therefore, our proof has done. There exists two ring homomorphism. One, f of P over Q equal to 0, and other, f of P over Q equal to P over Q. Are you getting? Well, now we will see the proof for set of irrational number. That means we have to show f of a equal to a, where a belongs to Q complement. I will approach it by real analysis. Consider two sequence an and bn belongs to rational number, that means set of all sequence of rational number, such that an less than a less than bn, then limit n tends to infinity, an equal to limit n tends to infinity, bn equal to, obviously, that means if we take any irrational number, then there must exist at least two sequence of rational number which converts to this irrational number. And this is true because irrational number is dense in R. Okay? We had seen in my earlier video, number of ring homomorphism from Zn to Zn. And I have solved this by finding the idempotent element. Similarly, here function is defined from Z12 to Z13. Just review how we will find the ring homomorphism by idempotent element. First, we have to find the number of idempotent element in Z30, which is equal to 2 to the power d, where d is prime divisor of 30, that means this is equal to just 8. That means there exist in Z30 8 idempotent element, and if you calculate, this will be 0, 1, 6, 10, 15, 16, 21, and 25. Then our method is, we have to find the order of this idempotent element in Z30. Here notice, order of 0 in Z30 equal to 1. Then, to find ring homomorphism, we have to find, is there exist any element in Z12 of order 1? Obviously, this is equal to 0. 0 has order of order 1. That means, this ring homomorphism is just trivial ring homomorphism. And for 1, in Z30, order of 1 equal to 30, there exists no element in Z12 of order 30. Similarly, order of 6 in Z30 equal to 5, and in Z12 there exists no element of order 5. So this ring homomorphism also not be possible. And for 10 in Z30, order of 10 equal to 3, and in Z12 4 has order 3. Similarly, order of 15 equal to 2, and in Z12, 6 has order 2. So, this two ring homomorphism possible. Similarly, order 16 equal to 15, and in Z12, there is just no element of order 15. So, there is this ring homomorphism cannot possible. And order of 21 equal to 10, there is no element of order 10. And order of 25 equal to 6, and in Z12, only 2 has order 6. So, possible ring homomorphism are fx equal to 0x, fx equal to 15x, fx equal to 10x, and fx equal to 25x. Process is very lengthy process to find the ring homomorphism. Let's see another process. Let's recall the group homomorphism. In Zm to Zn, we have find the group homomorphism by finding the GCD of M and N. If we consider Z12 to Z30, then number of group homomorphism is GCD of 12 and 30, which is equal to 6. Other method is, if you find the divisor of 30, this would be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. And divisor of 12 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. And for group homomorphism, we have to find this common part. 2, 2, 3, 3, 6, 6. Then, the count in group homomorphism is phi 1 equal to 1, phi 2 equal to also 1, phi 3 equal to 2, and phi 6 equal to 2. So, number of group homomorphism is 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 equal to 6. To find the group homomorphism, here order of 1, the element in Z30 is 0, Therefore, the mapping is f of x equal to 0x, and order of 2 in Z30 equal to 5. So mapping is look like f of x equal to 5x. 10 has order 2 in Z30. So mapping is look like f of x equal to 10x. And similarly, there exists 2 elements in Z30 of order 2, 10 and 15. So this mapping of order 2 and 6 of order 30 is 20 and 25. So the group homomorphism is f of x equal to 20x and f of x equal to 25x. This is the element of order 6. All are group homomorphism of this mapping. For ring homomorphism, we have to find in this mapping which are idempotent in Z30. Only 0, 5, 10, 15 and 25 be the idempotent element in Z30. And I think this is more easiest, this method. In any competitive exam, this will be very lengthy to find ring homomorphism by this method. Generalization of ring homomorphism is total number of ring homomorphism from Zm to Zn is 2 to the power omega n minus omega to the power n over GCD of Mn. Where this omega n represent number of prime divisor of n. And this is the shortcut method to find the ring homomorphism. And this process is very easiest process to find the ring homomorphism than the other process. Now let's see one question which had come in session net exam. Number of ring homomorphism from Z12 to Z28. Here the formula 2 to the power omega n minus omega to the power n over GCD of Mn. Just use the formula, then this is would be 2 to the power omega, here n means 28, minus omega to the power n mean 28, and GCD of 12 and 28 equal to just 4. Then notice 28 equal to 2 square times 7. So here the number of prime divisor of 28 is just 2, 2 and 7. That means this value would be 2 minus, here minus, and this is equal to 7. And prime divisor of 7 only 1, that means this is equal to just 1. That means this value is equal to just 1. And this is equal to 2. So, number of ring homomorphism from Z12 to Z20 is just 2. Are you getting how this method is easiest than other method? Oh well. I will stop here. And I hope my all viewers have understood about the ring homomorphism clearly. See you soon. Stay safe and stay positive always. And don't forget to do subscribe and to do the press of like button. Happy New Year again.